Everyone, I'm coming on. I'm just about to make some homemade gesso, so I thought I'd pop on and do it with you here. What you'll need is white acrylic paint, baby powder, anyone makes no difference, and PVA glue, although that's upside down. Okay, so I'm just leaving that there upside down so it runs. I'm going to take the seal off this. Things. Right. I think I'll just punch a wee hole in the middle. There we go. Clean my finger off. Right. And then just put in about a third. There we go. Oops, helps if I've got the right lid. Be careful. Then we've got talcum. I'm going to just take the lid off that and just gently put in about a third of that. And then add my glue. Ian, will you get me cereal when you're out, please? That's fine. Oops. Oops, it is. There we go. And you're just adding a wee bit now, because you'll need to add more of this. I'm filming, baby. He'll be back in a minute, he's only going to the wee hut.
Has he?
Uh-huh.
Back to go.
Yeah. And just give it a stir. And your talcum will absorb into the liquid, which will give you more room. You just give it a stir. Now, I like my gesso very, very thick, because then it means I don't need to put on 10 layers. There we go. We can give that a good mix about now. You will get a bit of talcum here and there, don't worry about that. Just give it a good mix about. And this works out so much cheaper than shop-bought gesso. Plus, if I am honest, this works out better for me. Plus the fact you're using baby powder, so there's a lovely smell off it. Right, more glue. Because that'll just help it bind. Give that another quick mix about. just make sure that you're mixing from the bottom up as well. And you'll see the consistency of that, it's really quite thick. That that's all in the tub. Right, and I'm going to try a wee bit on some chipboard. I've got a wee bit of scrap here. When I say scrap, it's not really because I will use it, but try a wee bit on that. So, a wee bit of tissue paper, wipe that off, and then just. And you'll see it coats the brush, it's not dripping off, so that's the consistency I like. I want to make sure that that's covered. Now looking at that, I'm going to need to add more white paint, because it's very translucent. As you'll see there, when that dries it'll be almost clear, and that's not what I want. I want it to be white, so I'll just add another bit of white paint to it. Right, just give me a minute and I'll do it. Just mixing that in. And again, I'm just making sure that I'm mixing it into it, and getting to the bottom. Just a second to fix his trainer if he's going to annoy the life out of me. And you know why that's like that? Because you just keep slipping them on and off. There we go. Right. So, put that back in the tub. And I'll give it another wee coat and see how we're going with that.
I'm sorry, YouTubers.
It's fine, on you go. So just that's a bit better. If I'm honest, I would probably like it a wee bit more white. If you see there, it's still a bit translucent. So I'm just going to add another wee bit of white paint in there. And it is just a game of keep going until you get what you want. I mean, that's definitely going to seal my paper. So if you're going to paint over it anyway with a different colour, it won't really matter. If it's not very white, translucent will be fine. A lot of people prefer clear gesso, so that would work just as well. I just prefer the white gesso, because if I'm adding napkins to a paper mache box, or I prefer that it is quite white and not see-through. So we'll try this again. And it's getting more like what I want. So you can see there. Okay, so that was my first one, which is very translucent. This one up here isn't much different. It's a wee bit whiter, and then we've got this one here. Okay, so you just play around with it until you get the colour that you're looking for. What I will say is, before you put your lid on your gesso, each time you use it, now I'm just going to wipe that off because there's plenty of medium on that and I'm not wasting it. Just put it back in your tub, get that a wipe off, and then just, where's my paper wipes? They're here. Just what to do is go round the rim and just give it a wipe. It will just prevent it from being sticky. Alright. And then just put your lid on. And that will keep forever. Do you know what I mean? It's not going to go off or go smelly. It will last for a long time. And as I said, with this talcum powder, that is just what it's for, is just my media. I use Johnson's on the wee man, but this is just for my arts and crafts. So that was like £1. My white paint was £3, I think. You can get it, I think it's 2 tubs for £5 out of the works. And I got my glue, I can't remember. I think I was probably, I want to say 7 or 9, but I might be wrong. I don't even know if I've got to search this in here. Brian Clegg. No. My internet's down just now, so I've not been able to check it. But I'll leave that in the description bar, much it is. But you can use any PVA glue. It could be the pound, out the pound shop. It doesn't matter, as long as it dries clear. In fact, it doesn't even need to dry clear if you're looking for white gesso. But if you're looking for a clear, then yeah, you would look for a dry clear. So that's my wee tip for today. So I hope it's helped, and I will speak to you all soon. Bye for now.